I'm Robbie Gordon, driver of the number 31 singular wireless Chevrolet. You're watching Comcast SportsNet.
As the first half comes to a close, the Phillies look to put some space between themselves and the second-place Braves. While the Phillies' future ace is on display in Houston, some Phils fans think the time is now.
Ed Wade's listening to this. He needs to do something. There's a lot of unhappy Phillies fans, and they know they need to make a move.
And lads keep up a pace in France. The heat is on. Wachovia Sports Night starts now. I recognize that guy. That is my partner tonight, Michael Barkan. Which one are you, Michael?
I don't know. I don't recognize anyone in that picture.
There you are. Hey, there you are.
I don't think so.
I thought it was Lance Armstrong, but that's Michael in our taking part in the 32nd annual American Cancer Society Bike-a-thon today.
I'm finished.
And he's finished, and he now joins us here in the studio for Wachovia Sports Night. You got your breath back? Welcome to the show alongside Michael Barkan, also known as Lance. I'm Ron Burke.
Ronnie B.
That would be me.
7 a.m. 7 a.m.
I'm proud of you.
We're still going strong.
Okay. You're the man.
Phillies,
that's one.
Different story. All-star break now upon us.
Thankfully.
Phillies at 46 wins after 87 games. It's a 528 winning percentage. That translates to 86 wins after 162. Good enough? Is it good enough? General Manager Ed Wade taking no chances. He continues to work the phones, trying to get the team some help for the final 75 games. Trade deadline is July 31st. According to St. Louis newspapers, the Cardinals have rejected the proposed deal of Kevin Millwood and Placido Polanco for Matt Morris and reliever Steve Kline. Reports now include the Phillies targeting Boston's Derek Lowe and the Expos' Levon Hernandez. We go to the game. Randy Wolf trying to give the Phillies a rare good outing from a starter, looking for his fourth win. Top of the second, scary moment. Ooh. Julio Franco loses his bat, flying into the stands, and hits a little kid. Watch it again. Little boy will be fine. That's not the first time today the bat goes into the stands. Wolf good early, gets Andrew Jones swinging. Always a tough chore. Wolfpack loving it. Bills get two runs early to help him out to the sixth, though. Into trouble. There's J.D. Drew getting the booze and getting the solo shot to tie the game at two. After walking Chipper Jones, Johnny Estrada goes deep to center. Ricky LeDay going back. Ricky LeDay can't get it. A double for Johnny Estrada. Why can't we get guys like him? Now two on for the ageless Franco. Takes Wolf deep to right center. That is gone. Three-run shot, and Randy Wolf can't believe it. Braves take a 5-2 lead. Wolf allows five runs on 10 hits and five and a third. There goes the glove.
Souvenir.
Souvenir for some young fan. When he gets pulled, tosses it into the stands. Bottom sixth, and there goes another bat, this time from Pat Burrell. And he hits a kid in the head. Fans concerned. Game actually stopped for a few seconds as paramedics treat the fan taken out. We're told by the Phillies that the injury does not appear to be serious. Still in the sixth, man on for David Bell. For whom the bell tolls, it tolls for thou. Takes Russ Ortiz deep to left and gone. Phillies now 1-5-4. They're within one run to the ninth. Billy Wagner, 1-2 count on John Smoltz. Wants strike three call. He's displeased. Larry Boa says, okay, you know what? Let me come out and talk to my closer, okay? Under the guise of talking to my closer. And then he gets into the face of home plate umpire Rob Drake. Drake comes to the mound, two exchanging words. Get out of here, Larry. He's tossed. Fans loving it. And then moments later, how about Gary Varsho, the acting manager? One out after taking over for Boa. He gets tossed. What are you doing that for? Bottom of the ninth. Phils down 6-4, two on, nobody out for Jim Thome. First pitch, he swings that, pops it up. Third base side, that's out number one. They got first and second, no outs. There's one out. Next batter, Pat Burrell. John Smoltz gets him to fly out to right. And two outs. Next batter, Ricky LeDay, get out. And the Phillies head into the All-Star break with back-to-back losses as they fall to the Braves 6-4. They end their 14-game homestand at 8-6. The Braves have now won 12 of their last 15. Boa's ejection, the 22nd of his 4 years as manager of the Phillies. The 1-6 spots in the Braves lineups were red hot Sunday. They racked up 14 of the Atlanta's 16 hits. And despite the loss, the Phillies enter the All-Star break right where they want to be.
Well, the Phillies go into the All-Star break, leading the National League East by one over Atlanta.
We're happy where we're at. We got some teams in our division that are playing well right now. And, you know, with the injuries and stuff and all that, I mean, we're happy where we're at. We'll take that and now come out in the second half and focus and see what we can do here.
We're still...
Looper to right center. Marlins get the run back. 5-2 Fish in the ninth. Armando Benitez gets Spencer swinging. It's a 1-2-3 inning for Benitez, who notches his 30th save. Marlins win 5-2 the final. It's the most competitive division in all of baseball, as three teams are within two games of the Phillies. The Braves made their patented run before the All-Star break. They are now just a game back, despite losing players like Javi Lopez, Gary Sheffield, and Greg Maddux. The defending world champs are a game and a half back, and the surprising Mets will be tough in the second half. They are two back. In a few moments, we'll hear from the Phillies on the second half of the season, and we'll check in with the fans. Are you happy with the Phils at the break, or perhaps a bit nervous at the All-Star break? And the one player that most teams want from the Phillies in a trade has been labeled untouchable by Ed Wade. Gavin Floyd is in action today at the All-Star Games Futures Contest. That's all coming up, Ron.
Thank you, sir. According to his agent, Shaquille O'Neal has decided to trade in the West Coast for South Beach. With a proposed trade between the Lakers and Heat all but done, agent Perry Rogers told the Washington Post both sides have agreed to the deal, but the trade cannot officially be completed until Wednesday, the first day trades and free agent signings can occur in the NBA. O'Neal's impending arrival in Miami is a big deal because the Eastern Conference is weak at center, and the already dominant big man figures to be even more of a factor with the Heat. Reportedly, Miami is one of five cities O'Neal told the Lakers he would consider. His agent disputes reports that said Shaq would require a contract extension with any trade, saying he has not discussed a new deal with the Heat. Shaq and his people met yesterday in Orlando with the Heat's people, and that group included President Pat Riley. The Heat advanced to the Eastern Conference semis this past season, but they will lose some of their key players who helped them get there in this trade for Shaquille O'Neal. According to reports, the Heat will send to the Lakers two of their key forwards. Lamar Odom was the Heat's second leading scorer last season at 17 points per. He was also their leading rebounder at just under 10 boards a game. Also headed west in the deal, forward Caron Butler, who is going into his third season. He averaged 9 points and just under 5 boards last season. His highest scoring game was a 30-point outing against the Bulls in late March, but injuries limited Butler to just 56 starts last season. So here are the players reported to be involved in the Shaquille O'Neal trade. Lamar Odom would go back to L.A. Remember, he began his career with the Clippers.
Chicago to Miami.
What's that?
Chicago to Miami.
Oh, is this English class? Caron Butler's scoring and rebounding numbers were down from his rookie year, but injuries had a hand in his fall off. The Lakers also would receive forward Brian Grant and a first-round pick. Shaq's scoring average dipped to a career-low 21 points per game this past season, and he has not played more than 67 games in any of the past 3 years due to injuries, which certainly could mean something as they look further down the line in his career. O'Neal is stated to make almost $28 million next season, and reportedly he has assured the Heat he will not opt out of his contract after next season. Elsewhere, a new Kmart could be opening in Atlanta soon. Reports in that city say the Hawks are prepared to offer Nets restricted free agent forward Kenyon Martin a maximum 6-year deal that could be worth as much as $85 million. If Martin signs an offer sheet when free agents are allowed to do so this coming Wednesday, the Nets would have 15 days to match it. In other player movement, according to numerous reports, the Pacers and Hawks are close to agreeing to a sign-and-trade deal that would send guard Steven Jackson to Indiana and forward Al Harrington to Atlanta. The Hawks are expected to re-sign Jackson to a 6-year deal worth at least $40 million before the trade is executed. Last season, he averaged 18 points and 4 rebounds in his first season with the Hawks.
Well, still a couple of weeks left the Tour de France. The party continues here on Wachovia Sports Night, although the tour hasn't really been a party for Lance Armstrong. How would he fare in another rainy day in France?
Also, Bobby Abreu provided one of the highlights of the first half of the season with a walk-off home run this past Thursday. We'll hear from the Phillies as they head into the break with a slim lead in the NL East.
And you don't see this very often. Stay tuned to see what had two pit crews throwing down at the Tropicana 400. Pro wrestling match breaks out on a NASCAR track in a moment.
This edition of Sports Night is brought to you by Wachovia.
Tomorrow, Mark and Jen are going to Wachovia for a free financial checkup to learn ways to lower payments, reduce fees, and pay for their children's education. The day after tomorrow, they'll pay for a week of band camp, a week of cyber camp, and 2 weeks of lacrosse camp. Come in today for your free financial checkup. Wachovia.
Real Phillies fans will lie, steal, and cheat to see their team in action. So find a way to see the Rockies August 9th, 10th, or 12th at 7:05, or join us on the 11th when kids get a Phillies retro t-shirt courtesy AAA Mid-Atlantic. Order tickets now.
The Landmark Americana Tap and Grill in Glassboro, New Jersey is the official bar of Comcast SportsNet. Each week all summer long, come in for your chance to win Phillies tickets and enter for the grand prize. 4 tickets to a Phillies game with a Comcast SportsNet suite. Plus, a behind-the-scenes tour of Citizens Bank Park. Enter to win at Landmark Americana Tap and Grill, where you can catch the Phillies games on Comcast SportsNet. Enjoy the happy hour specials or nightly entertainment. See you there.
We're back with a good cause. The man to my left, Michael Barkan, today took part in the 32nd annual American Cancer Society Bike-a-thon. Mayor John Street also rode in the longest single-day biking event in the Philadelphia area. Organizers were hoping to top the $857,000 raised last year at the events.
Hey, great cause as well, and raised $1 million. That was the goal. Who are you riding for was the question of the day. 3,500 riders over the bridge. Well, stay away from the crashes that have plagued many riders so far. Stay in the pack and wait until the mountain stages to do your damage. That's been Lance Armstrong's game plan so far in the Tour de France. As the Tour entered stage 8 today, Armstrong right where he wanted to be, just under 10 minutes behind the leader in 6th place. Stage 8, 104-mile trek through the north of France. Includes 4 modest climbs, not to mention rain again. Lance Armstrong, as he's done all week, not pushing his luck, just riding in the main pack. Another crash. What would the Tour be like without a crash? 4.5 miles from the end, none of the main contenders involved. Sprint to the finish. Tour, Hushoff, with a burst of speed at the end. Win stage 8. Lance Armstrong finished in 33rd, but in the main pack, so he did not lose any time. Armstrong is 6th overall, 55 seconds ahead of his main rival, Jan Ulrich. Both riders are trying to avoid crashes and getting ready for the mountain stages on Tuesday. First come Les Pyrenees and then the Alps. The riders have an off day tomorrow, one of just 2 off days during the tour. Not getting a day off, though, is Outdoor Life Network's Al Troutwig, who has more on a wild first week of the tour.
Tour de France updates brought to you by Bicycle Therapy.
The region of France known as Brittany is an awfully beautiful place, but it's known for some awfully bad weather. Wind and rain, certainly true to form here, greeting the 176 cyclists that cycled 2 stages here in northwestern France. Through the first week of the tour, we have seen 2 things dominate. 1, bad weather, we haven't had 1 hot day, and crashes, knocking 12 riders out of the tour. The other major story has been the 2 major statements made in the 2 shortest elements of the Tour de France so far. First, in the prologue, just short of 4 miles, Lance Armstrong was number 2, but faster than all his rivals. Then he carried that momentum into the team time trial, when his U.S. Postal Squad was number 1, keeping him number 1 in terms of the overall potential yellow jersey wearers. After that, his team sat back and watched a sprinting specialist by the name of Thomas Vogler grab the yellow jersey, and he has held that honor for the last 4 days. So the story has repeated itself over and over and over again. Next up, a day off for the cyclists. They fly into Limoges, famous for its porcelain, as the approach for the Pyrenees Mountains comes closer. This is where Lance Armstrong hopes to dominate, as he has in years past. This is when you can demoralize your opponent on steep hills that are beyond mind-boggling. It is the Pyrenees, then the Alps, and still plenty of more cycling to come. We've covered 1,000 miles in the Tour, and right now Lance Armstrong remains where he wants to be. From France, Al Trautwig. Let's go back to the Comcast SportsNet studio.
All right, Al, thank you. Tonight on the Outdoor Life Network, beginning at 8:30, they will rebroadcast their pre-race show, and at 9, they will show you stage 8 again of the Tour de France, along with some expanded coverage here from the riders and the experts tonight on OLN at 8:30. Another sport with wheels, the Tropicana 400, and if Tony Stewart is the bad boy of NASCAR today, doesn't help him. Lap 125, Stewart behind race leader Casey Kane. Stewart bumps him and sends Kane into the wall. And then tempers flare in the pits as Kane's pit members confront Stewart and a brawl breaks out in the pits. Something not seen very often in NASCAR. Lap 241, Stewart manages to get back in his car and dominate, leads most of the race, passes Jeremy Mayfield to take back the lead, and in the end, it's Stewart hanging on for his first win of the 2004 season, leading for 160 laps of the race.
Well, the Phillies have made it clear they have no intention of promoting AA pitcher Gavin Floyd to the majors anytime soon. Until Floyd arrives someday, we'll have to settle for peaks here and there. And we got one today, as the 21-year-old was the lone Phillies minor league player in the Futures game in Houston. This is a prelude to the Major League All-Star festivities at Minute Maid Park. And Floyd into the game in the seventh and final inning to close things out for the U.S. Futures team, but in a tough spot. Bases loaded, nobody out, and they bring him in. First batter he faces, Felix Pye, singles to right. And then the next batter, Robinson Cano, but Floyd gets him to ground to first. Floyd covers, another run scores. It's 4-2 U.S. Next batter is Justin Morneau, and Floyd throws the pitch in the dirt. It gets past the catcher. Another run scores, so it's now one run lead for the U.S. team. Floyd then comes back and gets his well-known curveball in there for the strikeout. Floyd goes two-thirds of an inning, and the U.S. team would hold on to beat the world team by a final of 4-3. Well, Comcast SportsNet will be in Houston for the All-Star festivities. Our Leslie Goodell will begin her reports from Minute Maid Park, beginning tomorrow on Daily News Live and also on Wachovia Sports Night. The Home Run Derby set for tomorrow night. The All-Star game itself will be Tuesday night. Leslie again handling our extensive coverage beginning tomorrow on DNL.
Well, Leslie will be there. So will Ken Griffey Jr., but not as a player. Jr. went on the 15-day disabled list today with a partial tear of his right hamstring right there. Suffered in yesterday's loss to the Brewers. Griffey will participate in the All-Star game festivities, but he will not play in the game or the Home Run Derby. Lance Berkman is likely to start in center, and Carlos Beltran has been added to the NL All-Star roster.
That's cool. They added Beltran. That's really cool. He made it in the American League.
You're right.
That's impressive.
There you go. Here's some scores in the National League today. We're going quickly here. Ready? Reds 9, Brewers 6, Expos 2-1 over the Pirates. Diamondbacks going down to the Giants big in the bottom of the 8th. Padres 4-2 over the Rockies in the 9th. Astros trailing the Dodgers. They lose to the Dodgers, and the Cubs Cards an 8:05 start.
Well, the Phillies have reached the midway point of their season. We polled the fans, and they have a message for the team's GM when we come back.
If Ed Wade's listening to this, he needs to do something. There's a lot of unhappy Phillies fans, and they know they need to make a move. They really need to make it, especially for a starting pitcher.
Hoop It Up presented by Powerade. The ultimate three-on-three basketball experience is back. New in 04 Powerade presents King James Court. Play one-on-one against other Hoop It Up players. One player and their guest will win a trip to Cleveland to meet LeBron James. Male or female, young or old, get your team together and hit the hardtop. For more information, visit hoopitup.com. Because if you like basketball, you'll love this. Hoop It Up returns to Philadelphia July 24th and 25th at Franklin Mills. Pick up an entry form at local area Finish Line stores. Log on to hoopitup.com or call 215-416-9032. Because if you like basketball, you'll love this.
Diamonds, the gift she really wants. The Jewelry Factory has thousands of diamonds, most with GIA or EGL certs, laser inscribed and guaranteed the lowest price. The Jewelry Factory has thousands of mountings, and your diamond is set while you wait. 1 carat solitaires are $5.99. Marquee solitaires are $3.99, and 1 carat studs are $3.99. The Jewelry Factory carries most shapes and sizes, including 5 carats and above. You can't beat our deals. Buy Factory Direct and save, the jewelry factory in Norristown.
When you want a new carpet and you want it done right, say Keppel's, Keppel's Carpet. When you want a new floor and you want to pay less, it's Keppel's, Keppel's Carpet. We're the outlet store with so much more. More savings, more service, more selection for sure. For carpet and savings, go with the best. K-E-P-P-L-E-S, Keppel's Carpet.
We're back on Wachovia Sports Night, and the Phillies could have made a statement in their 14-game homestand leading up to the All-Star break the same way the Braves have made statements in past years. The Phillies began with two straight wins, but overall they finished just 8-6 on the homestand and have to face the Mets, Braves, Marlins, and Cubs right out of the chute following the All-Star break. And the Phillies know the importance of getting off to a good start coming out of the break.
Every team we've got concerns us. I mean, we haven't played well against the East, period. Montreal, I mean, Montreal's give us fits at times, so, you know, I just think we need to continue to go out and play hard. I don't think we can look at one team as not a concern as much as anybody else.
Well, every time you lose, the team gains ground, and there's, you know, two, three teams that are right there. you know, so that means with that happening, you have to take each game by game. You can't look ahead. You can't look to a series that, you know, if you're playing a team, you can't look to the next series. You got to focus on that series that day, and you know, and then look up, and then next thing you know, you're playing well.
Jim Thome and team have a new stadium. They've got a payroll nearing $100 million, and they head into the All-Star break with a slim lead on the pack in the NL East. So, are Phillies fans happy? Are you? We took to the parking lot today before the game to check the pulse of the fans, and many want to see the Phils make a move before the July 31st trading deadline.
I think Ed Wade seriously needs to make a trade, get some kind of big name, because if not, I don't think they can hold on to first place by the end of the season. I think the Marlins or the Mets will catch up with them.
First, we got to get a steady center fielder. We got to trade for Finley. We got to get Finley. Bring him in. We should have got Beltran, but we got to go out and make a move because we're not going to make a pennant race without a center fielder.
I need a center fielder and a pitcher, starting pitcher. Randy Johnson and Steve Finley.
I think we got to look at some pitching. I mean, I think we're going to the bullpen too much. And, you know, our closers, you know, Wagner, everybody's reading Wagner on his fastball. He throws a good slider, but I think we have to improve in the pitching.
If Ed Wade's listening to this, he needs to do something. There's a lot of unhappy Phillies fans, and they know they need to make a move. They really need to make it, especially for a starting pitcher.
I'm happy with who they got. I wish they'd win a little bit more.
Phillies in first place. I can't wait to play the Marlins again. I think we can beat them this time. Bobby Bray's playing. I think he's the best player on the team right now. Tommy, he's red hot, and I think we're going to go all the way.
All right, and as we break, more of Sunday's Glove American Style.
With all our differences, isn't it remarkable that so many people love the same car, the Toyota Camry? Why is it the number one selling car in America? Well, Camry is quick and agile. That appeals to a certain kind of driver. And everyone loves its famous reliability. And now, at Toyota's Summer Savings Wave, you can get great deals on all 17 Toyota models, including Camry. Now just 2.9% financing or $1,000 cash back. So hurry to Toyota's Summer Savings Wave. With 17 models to choose from, which Toyota will you be waving from?
Music that became the soundtrack of our lives returns to the stage live. Journey, July 20th at Sovereign Bank Arena. The journey continues.
Anywhere you want, that's the way.
With their very special guest stars, the Fabulous Thunderbirds. Reserve seats are on sale now at the box office or Ticketmaster. Journey.
Looking around for a practical, affordable car? Running over here? Running over there? It would be a lot easier to go to vehix.com. Vehix.com has everything you need to know. Models, packages, standard equipment, options, reviews, and prices all in one website. Making shopping for a practical car, well, a lot more practical. The all-new, easy-to-use vehix.com. Roadmap to the automotive world.
I don't need drugs to be cool.
Drugs are wrong. Stay strong.
Don't do drugs and follow your dreams.
Friends don't let friends do drugs.
I'm proud to be drug free.
Be smart. Say no to drugs.
There's no need to smoke weed.
Don't do drugs!
This message brought to you by the Cable Telecommunications Association of Maryland, Delaware, and D.C.
Hello?
Yes.
Yes.
It's time to say goodbye.
We're out of time. We're just doing the math here. They played Montreal. Phillies played Montreal, Baltimore, the Mets, and the Braves. 8-6 at home. They took 3 out of 4 from Montreal, 2 out of 3 from Baltimore, split with the Mets, and 1 out of 3 from the Braves.
Progressively worse in each of those 4 series.
Not a way to go into the break.
No, indeed.
We're back to recount coming up at 10 o'clock.
He's Michael. I'm Ron. Be good.
See you later.
This edition of Sports Night is brought to you by Wachovia. This summer, you laughed at a funny green ogre. You marveled at a comic book hero. Now, don't miss the one big blockbuster of the summer. Ford Authorized Clearance. Get 0% financing. Get up to $5,000 cash back on the Ford vehicles that have received awards and accolades all year long. Ford Authorized Clearance. The one big event you can't miss.